In November of 2015, Smash fans around the world glued their eyes to their screens as a new DLC character trailer for Smash 4 began. Little did we know that this trailer would reveal one of the most unexpected and unbelievable crossovers in Smash history. As the stars twinkled in the opening scene, hardcore Final Fantasy fans already knew what to expect, and everyone else knew a few moments later when the title appeared on screen. Excitement reached its climax as Cloud Strife himself appeared on his Midgar stage, confirmed as a new fighter in Smash 4. Cloud's popularity made him a common pick by many top players upon release, and his amazing moveset potential began to cement him as one of the best characters in the game. Before he even swung his gigantic Buster Sword, Cloud ran, or glided, quickly on the ground and drifted swiftly through the air with great overall mobility. The range on his sword attacks was incredible, with his up air in particular becoming the greatest juggling option in the game. If that wasn't enough, Cloud's limit let him control the pace of the game and unlocked insanely strong special moves and even better mobility. At the end of Smash 4, Cloud was considered to be the second best character in the game, falling short only to Bayonetta. In Smash Ultimate, Cloud returned as a veteran fighter, but most Cloud players felt that he had left a lot behind in Smash 4. Most obviously, his range was diminished quite a bit on every sword attack. This is most apparent on his neutral air, which seems almost as if Cloud is trying to hold the sword closer to his body. His up air, while still a good juggling move, shrunk quite a bit, such that his devastating falling up air setups from Smash 4 are virtually non-existent. Sadly, or maybe not sadly if you were one of the many victims oppressed by the brutal anime swordsman in Smash 4, the nerfs don't end there. Cloud's limit charge was made much slower. He incurs 7 frames of lag after canceling limit charge. And limit itself disappears automatically after only 15 seconds, which is a lot less than the infinity it lasted in Smash 4 if left unused. Not to mention that all of his limit specials are weaker as well. For some reason, Cloud's grab was also nerfed, with all variations of his grab receiving 2 additional frames of startup, making them quite sluggish. Cloud did, however, receive some buffs coming into Ultimate. He now has access to high damage, low percent combos into cross slash. His up B is now an amazing out of shield punish that connects consistently, and directional air dodging diversifies his linear recovery. Still, with all of the nerfs, many players considered Cloud mid-tier or high-tier at best in Ultimate. That is, until patch 7.0.0 came along. If you want to learn more about Cloud and see where he falls on our tier list, check out the Smash section on our website, ProGuides.com. While you're there, you can access exclusive features like our Play with Pros platform and our pro courses with top players like MKLeo. Now, on with the video. Although excitement levels for the new DLC character Byleth were lukewarm, the Smash community was eager and a bit anxious as usual to get a look at the balance changes brought in the new 7.0.0 update. This new patch actually buffed quite a few characters and happened to nerf some, but for Cloud players, this patch was amazing. Cloud received a number of buffs, which clearly show that the developers care about the character and his players. Let's take a look at the changes and see what they really did for Cloud. The first change says, extended launch distance when hit in the high damage range for dash attack. Launch distance refers to knockback, and the high damage range refers to the strong hit of dash attack. So this means that the strong hit of dash attack is now a stronger KO move that has more knockback. While dash attacks still won't KO until at least around 130% in most matchups, having a fast, disjointed kill option out of a dash is still a big deal. This move was already a great tool for trapping landings, whiff punishing, and sometimes ledge trapping, and with the increased knockback, Cloud can find KOs from these situations or at least send the opponent further off stage, making edge guards easier. Next, the patch notes list Cloud's side smash with the change made it easier to hit multiple times. This just means that the multi-hits of Cloud's forward smash will connect into each other more reliably. It wasn't particularly common to see someone fall out of this move, but thanks to this patch, that unintended mishap will be less likely. For Cloud's up smash, it says, extended launch distance when hit with the sword tip and increased attack speed. These changes are among the most significant buffs Cloud received. His up smash is noticeably stronger now, taking stocks at 115 or earlier. This move was already quite large, making it a strong anti-air and landing punish, and now the reward for hitting it is much greater. Not only is Cloud's up smash stronger, it's also significantly faster, going from frame 15 to frame 12. Being 3 frames faster makes this move much easier to throw out on reaction, and now it's a very practical out of shield option to punish laggy moves, even if they're well spaced. Since Cloud's grab is so slow, his up smash is now actually a faster out of shield option than his shield grab. And combined with his up B out of shield makes Cloud very scary to pressure. This will result in players running away from Cloud more often, which gives him more time to charge limit and more room to space his aerials. Up next is Cloud's up special with a change that says increased the speed of the edge grab timing. What this means is that Cloud's up B, which is notoriously edgeguardable for not auto-snapping the ledge, will grab the ledge earlier. This makes it much easier for Cloud to recover without getting gimped, and no longer requires him to sweet spot his up B perfectly. Because of this, he has more flexibility to mix up the timing of his up B and has a buffed recovery in general without limit. Speaking of limit, the next change lists Cloud's down special with the change increased the speed at which the gauge fills up with limit charge. As the description suggests, Cloud's manual limit charge now charges faster. This might be the single most important buff. Cloud's limit now charges a full 2 seconds faster, dropping from around 8 seconds to around 6 seconds. With limit, Cloud is certainly still a top tier character, and now he'll be able to switch into his top tier mode much more often. This buff also makes limit charge camping a more practical strategy, so Cloud can slow down the pace of a game and force approaches. Of course, all of these changes are without mentioning that Cloud's shield is also a little bigger now. So how do these changes help Cloud overall? In the current meta, Cloud is a character who relies on aerial spacing in neutral, looking for forward airs and back airs at low percents to combo into cross slash for damage. At mid percents, Cloud wants to put you above him or off stage so he can pursue with back airs, nairs, and up airs. This gives him time to build up his limit, which is very important to his kill potential. Cloud's limit cross slash can be used as a whiff punish or even an edgeguard and kills very early near the blast zone. The change to his limit charge makes Cloud's advantage state much stronger, making it far more likely that he'll have limit available when his opponent is in a tight spot. His advantage state is also buffed by the dash attack and up smash changes, making it easier for Cloud to turn juggles into KOs and knocking opponents further away, which gives him more time to charge his limit. In neutral, Cloud is now more flexible as he can run away and charge limit more practically. Getting limit more often is great for neutral too, as his enhanced physics make Cloud's mobility more ambiguous and the threat of his limit cross slash conditions opponents to run away and shield. At higher percents, his up smash buffs can make it dangerous to approach him from the air or hit a shield, as doing so haphazardly can easily result in a loss of a stock. As for disadvantage, Cloud's main struggle is recovery. Without limit, his up B doesn't travel very far and it can only move straight up and down vertically. This makes Cloud very susceptible to gimps, as his recovery is quite telegraphed and often requires him to burn his double jump. Although all of this is still true, the change to up B that lets it snap to ledge sooner makes it much harder for opponents to interrupt Cloud once he actually gets in range for his up B to grab ledge. Also, the limit charge buff increases the likelihood that Cloud will have limit when he's recovering, so he can use his amazing limit climb hazard to easily return to stage. This also means that he'll be able to go for more edgeguards, since he can recover very far with limit. The charge speed increase can make clutch offstage charges lead to recoveries more often as well. This patch definitely helps Cloud a lot, potentially solidifying him as a high-tier character. There are still some crucial changes that Cloud would need to be a top tier, however. Having such slow grabs is certainly one big issue. His standing grab is frame 9, dash grab is 12, and his pivot grab is frame 13. This doesn't exactly make his grabs reactable, but anytime he would attempt to grab as a punish, it would likely be too slow. Cloud doesn't get much reward off of his throws either, but having poor grabs makes opponents more likely to get away with shielding a lot against him. Despite the range nerfs, most of Cloud's aerials are still pretty big, but his neutral air... yeah, that's the one people compare to a toothpick. Now, its range in Smash 4 was a bit excessive, but it doesn't need to be quite so small in this game, and a nair size buff would give Cloud a better safe landing and edgeguarding option. Limits, well, limit is one of the hugest nerfs to Cloud as well. Keeping limit forever until it's used might be too broken, but the 15 seconds Cloud gets now is half of the time Joker gets to keep Arsene, which is arguably a much better power-up. Joker doesn't even lose Arsene when he uses its attacks. Giving Cloud 30 seconds of limit time would be a huge change, and coupled with these other potential buffs, might be enough to put Cloud back in top tier. Are you happy to see that Cloud was buffed? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe to ProGuides and turn on notifications so you never miss a thing.